We're going to now, for the rest of the hour, have Catherine Austin Fitz, who's on her vacation. She says she's in the beautiful mountains of the West. And of course, we had media, the USA Today earlier, saying that the government may need to ban music that's uplifting. It's a form of drugs. Folks, if you just tuned in, I'm not joking. Web delivers new worry for parents. Digital drugs. Music that's uplifting is a drug. I bet she sounded on the phone earlier, the guy said, uplifted by being in a cabin in the mountains. That's evil. And the government has a vaccine that will cure her of emotion. Catherine Austin Fitz is an investment advisor, founder, and managing director of Solari Investment Advisor Services. Entrepreneur, president of the Hamilton Securities Group, investment bank and financial software developer, government official, assistant secretary of housing, federal housing commissioner, Bush the first, investment banker, managing director, and member of the board of the elite Wall Street firm, Dylan Reed & Co. Didn't get any more elite than that. Catherine has designed and closed more than $25 billion of transactions and investments to date and has led portfolio strategies of $300 billion in financial assets and liabilities. I wanted to get her on about the deepening depression, what's happening with currencies, the Iran situation, and so much more. Catherine, good to have you here with us.
Alex, it's always uplifting to hear you. if somebody has had enormous Derber problems, I can't tell you how much I empathize with your situation. I remember, I don't know if you remember this, there was one 24-hour period when every time we tried to go to your site, we'd get sent to a mirror site that looked like yours, but that would give us a virus. Do you remember when that happened?
We've had all sorts of tricks. What that must have been was a virus on your computer. It's called scumware, basically, that takes over your computer when you put something in and then shows you tailored ads that look like the website. So that wasn't actually my site. We've had that happen.
It was our virus. Well, who knows? But all I can tell you is somebody really had it in for InfoWars that day.
Well, you know, this is just that Drudge linked to one of our backup auxiliaries that we're going to move to a beefier server. It's actually on the PrisonPlanet.tv server. That's a bunch of servers together. So PrisonPlanet.tv is having problems. So is Infowars.net. We just purchased a bunch of other big servers in our own server farm here in Austin. We're building that right now. That was a capital improvement of $55,000, a lot of money for us, thanks to listener support. So we're not just spread out all over the world, but also have this as backups. But for now, this key Drudge Report link is deader than a doornail, but we'll survive it. We're going to make pre-crime the number one search today. Our wonderful listeners have never failed. But Catherine, great to have you here with us. You've got the floor for the rest of the segment. I mean, I'm not going to interrupt you. Break down what's happening in the economy, everything you predicted, where this is going, housing starts, and existing home sales, the lowest. The headline says in 15 years, but the article actually says since the 1960s, 1968. And now the media is saying, it's not really a double-dip recession. It could be a depression.
Well, we're not going through a depression or recession. We're going through re-engineering. And governance of resources on planet Earth is in the process of being re-engineered. I call it a financial coup d'etat. And what we're watching is an economy that's very managed. It's a political economy. And so the different market frameworks you hear people talk about in the financial area, in some respects, aren't appropriate, Alex. And one of the things I want to make very clear about the current economy, if you said to me, you know something, Catherine, you're a portfolio strategist. Just reoptimize the economy to create as much wealth as possible. What I would tell you is the wealth that we could create, whether it's human capital or environmental capital or financial capital, is hundreds of multiples greater than what we have now. In other words, our economy is totally constrained by the desire of the people at the top to want to have total control. And the more you institute total control, the less healthy the economy is. And so we don't have an economic problem at all because the potential for wealth and abundance is unbelievable. What we have is a political problem, and that translates into cultural problems. So
they want to control it and hog it and be able to dominate it. I said, "Want to interrupt, but I can't help it. You're so smart. You're absolutely right." And they know that. They know when they raise taxes, it drives down the economy. They admit it. They want control. They want to destroy it to consolidate it, as you've said.
Right. And here's the thing. For 500 years, the you know, sort of the Western world has functioned on what I call the central banking warfare model. That's our paradigm. So the central banks print money, and then the military makes sure they take it, and we get cheap access to natural resources. And the reality is, Alex, that you and I have been the beneficiary of that. Most people in America have been the beneficiary of this model. You know, how did we get the land we're standing on right now? Well, we killed all the people who were here. Let's not be naive about how we got what we got. So the central banking warfare model has continued, and the reality is it's not going to work anymore. It has to change. And you have a group of the leadership who are saying, okay, well, we have a plan to change it because it's no longer going to work. And our plan, you know, you and I refer to it as the New World Order, but it centralizes things. It gives much more totalitarian control, and it depopulates. Because let's face it, if we're going to live this way, you know, with 6 billion people going to 9 billion, there's going to be the real environmental issues unless you unsuppress technology, which threatens control. And so they've got a plan. And the reality, Alex, is we need a different plan. And what needs to happen is people globally need to come together and start talking about, okay, let's come up with an alternative plan that addresses all the issues. Because one thing I will say in defense of the New World Order's plan, they're addressing all the issues. Now, I don't like the way they're doing it, and I don't think it's going to work. I mean, the reason I ended up, you know, on a radio show with you and having that opportunity as opposed to sitting on Wall Street is I don't think their plan's going to work. I don't want to be part of it. It's disgusting to me. I don't want total control.
Well, that's a moral position, too, and money isn't everything. Doing the right thing is so fulfilling, and being part of the human community and standing up against tyranny, as soon as you do that, you have a lot more energy. You feel good about yourself. I mean, so many people I talk to who are depressed or unhappy, the media makes them feel inadequate. All of this Madison Avenue culture is to make you think you're ugly and stupid. We are beautiful, wonderful creatures who can appreciate beauty. You know, for me, Catherine, just the fact that our eyes and our mind can appreciate a beautiful mountain vista or a sunrise or a bouquet of flowers or a beautiful woman, or if you're a woman, a handsome man, the fact that I can appreciate the innocence and enlightenment of my innocent children and literally see God through them. It's like that line in The Road when he's talking to Robert Duvall. And you know, the guy's saying, my son is like a god. And he says to him, yes, but in this dangerous world, you know, that's a dangerous thing. I mean, I'm paraphrasing. I'm not saying my children are gods.
Right.
I'm saying through that, I can see what really matters.
Well, but let's go back to the scripture. You know, Jesus said, what I can do, you can do. And that's true. In that sense, we all have that capacity to be of God. Why shouldn't we? I mean, why shouldn't we go to the very highest and excellent that we can be? And the challenge is that, you know, there are a group of people who feel that that would be, you know, that would make us very difficult to control. Now, in their defense, let me just go back, because I think it's important to look at this from what I call Mr. Global's point of view. Mr. Global is sort of my cartoon character for the people running things. And that is, you know, in their experience, Alex, the central banking warfare model and top-down control and force has always worked. In other words, and let me go back to the scripture just because there are stories people understand. If you look at the story of the crucifixion, remember, the Romans knew it was very bad karma to kill Jesus. They didn't want to do it. You know, Pontius Pilate was trying to figure out how to get out of it. And so he invited the crowd to choose who they wanted crucified, Jesus or the criminal, and the crowd chose Jesus. So the crowd got manipulated into you know, basically supporting the criminal and killing the good guy. And that's been the leadership's experience, that being honest and hardworking and doing the right thing and financial responsibility doesn't pay. And I'll tell you a very funny story. I was in London in 2001 giving a paper, and I describe this in my article, Financial Coup d'Etat. If you just do a search from under my name for Financial Coup d'Etat, you'll pick it up. And I was asked to give a paper, which was called The Myth of the Rule of Law, about the corruption in America, but from a investor's point of view and explaining sort of the economics of the government budget and how the government money was really being used to sort of corrupt the whole place. And this was a huge sort of transfer to the insiders that was not economic. And anyway, so there was a guy in the audience who was clearly sent over. You know, the boys in America had sent him over to, like, you know, watch me and destroy my credibility. Is that the music?
Yeah, when we come back, finish the story. I didn't want to interrupt you. Stay there. Catherine Austin Fitz will give you her website as well straight ahead. And by the way, Drudge must be listening because about 10 minutes ago, he switched over to PrisonPlanet.com. I want to say hi to Matt Drudge. We'll be right back. Stay with us.